Good morning from NASA's Johnson Space Center. This is Mission Control Houston. You're looking at the International Space Station Flight Control Room on this Thursday morning, September 19th, 2013. A team of flight controllers watching over systems aboard the International Space Station as this team has been on console since early this morning, being led by Flight Director Mike Lammers. He is joined on console by Leslie Ringo to his right, who is handling the communications link between this team and the crew on board the International Space Station. That crew of Expedition 37 is comprised of Commander Fyodor Yurchikhin, along with two flight engineers, Luca Parmitano from the European Space Agency, represented by the Italian Space Agency, and U.S. astronaut Karen Nyberg from the United States. Obviously, these two crew members, along with Commander Yurchikhin from the Russian Space Agency, representing Russia, of course, have been in space now for, they're on their 114th day aboard the International Space Station, after their single-day launch to rendezvous on their Soyuz spacecraft, known as a TMA-09M vehicle, back on May 28th. They plan to return home on November 10th after 166 days in space. They have focused their attention today on experiment work, focusing around the human research facility of the station, with blood and urine sample periodic taking, along with some additional ocular health for the crew members, and some ultrasound training for the crew members, along with some data takes in support of the ongoing efforts to understand how the human body reacts to the microgravity environment of space and changes over long duration periods of time. The crew members also have performed some routine housekeeping chores around the station, and have also been updated on the progress of a new cargo vehicle on its way to the International Space Station. Orbital Sciences Cygnus spacecraft launched just before 11 a.m. Eastern Time on Wednesday, on a trajectory profile to the southeast that puts it in line in the same plane, if you will, with the International Space Station, leading toward an arrival and berthing to the complex's Harmony Nadir port, the Earth-facing port on the Harmony node, on Sunday morning, with a targeted berthing time of just about 6:25 a.m. U.S. Central Time. All parameters on the Cygnus are in excellent shape. The vehicle has performed a number of tests on its way to the station over the course of the several days, including so far a position and attitude control test, a free drift test, and an active abort demonstration. All of those proves the navigation of the spacecraft using a global positioning system, and also puts it in good shape to support that rendezvous activity. Over the course of the next several days, a continued series of rendezvous maneuvers will take place using thrusters on the cargo vehicle before it arrives at the station in the wee hours on Sunday. So the crew on board is also getting ready for its arrival with an installation of the robotic workstation software to follow along and be ready for the robotic capture that will be handled primarily by Luca Parmitano aboard the station. So the crew obviously staying very busy on board and greatly anticipating the arrival of that new cargo vehicle, the first ever space station mission launched from the coast of Virginia at the Wallops Flight Facility.